Hard hitting.
So all look out.
Momentum killing.
Right in on Howard. Big stop on Foligno.
Game controlling.
Passes this time. Got it back. What a play by Datsu.
Power.
Scores! Point shot Danny DeKeyser.
Why does defense win championships? We find out next on Wingspan. Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to Wingspan. I'm your host, Trevor Thompson. While this season has seen a lot of attention paid to the Red Wings' goal scorers, both novice and veterans, just as much or more of Detroit's recent success is due to improved play defending their own turf. In the next half hour, we'll line up with an improved blue line presence as the Wings defend the D. Coming up in the show, the 89-year history of the Detroit Red Wings has seen some downright brilliant D-men wear the winged wheel, from certifiable legends to promising young talent. But defense isn't the responsibility of only two-fifths of the men on the ice. As Mickey York will show us, Red Wings hockey means some killer two-way forwards back-checking on every shift. Then Matt Shepard takes a look at the flip side of the coin when he examines the improvements this season's Wings blue liners have made to jumping up on the attack. But when the inevitable happens and opposing players get through, the last line of defense lies between the pipes. Wings goaltending has been suffocating this season, led by starter Jimmy Howard. But first, in his second full season with the Red Wings, Brendan Smith seems to have found his groove. I talked to the scrappy defenseman for a behind-the-scenes look at his breakout performance. There was a time when Red Wings defenseman Brendan Smith had the reputation as a bit of a riverboat gambler. But as any good gambler will tell you, you gotta know when to hold them and know when to fold them. Lesson Smith has learned by trial and error.
Ultimately, I like to use that word risk-reward. You want to make the right play at the right time, but sometimes it's hard. But most of the time, I think I've been making a better play and making it smarter, and that's been effective for at least myself so far.
And knocked away by Brendan Smith.
That lesson applies not only to play in either zone, but to dropping the gloves as well. Smith has gotten injured in fights at untimely points in a game the past few seasons, and his absence has cost his team. More lessons learned.
Injuries will happen, and that's something that I've had a few fluke ones, but so that's something that you want to minimize, but at the same time, you have to sometimes answer the bell, and I've done that, and I think that's still a learning process for myself, is choosing the right moments. I think so far I've done an all right job of it, but it's still a learning process.
And from Brian Lashoff to Jakob Kindle to Xavier Ouellette, Smith has also had to learn to play with different partners.
Having a different partner can be difficult. I mean, you want to have that familiarity with your partner, where they're going to be at the right time or what their skills are and their skill set can help you with.
But Mike Babcock has settled on a pairing with Xavier Ouellette of late, and it seems to be working for all concerned.
You need to have a good chemistry with your partner. You need to know where he's going to be, and you need to talk a lot and try to help each other out. I mean, that's the whole point of a partnership. He's a good skater, and if sometimes he seems like he's a little in trouble, he's a good enough skater to get back in position and catch the guy and stuff like that. So it makes it easy on me. He's always going to be first on puck and stuff like that.
You don't have to worry who they're on the ice against. You just play them. And so what you do with them is you play your top four less, which I think is so important. When you're yanking your guys off because you're scared to have them out in D-zone face-offs, your top four play too much and you wear your team out.
That's huge, and I think it's huge for the team. I mean, you can't just be playing your top two lines or your top two D-pairings. You'll run them into the ground because it's a long season.
Smith has shown a nose for offense. His defensive game is growing by leaps and bounds, and he's willing to defend himself and his teammates. That type of versatility is what made the 25-year-old a former first-round pick, and it's why his role is ever-increasing in Coach Babcock's system.
All you want to do is play more minutes. I mean, that's the biggest thing. Everybody here is so competitive. You want to play more, and by being versatile, that helps you play more minutes and play bigger minutes.
Great work by number two, Smith. Wow.
The new a defenseman these days have to be a little more skilled. We got to skate and be just as skilled as the forwards.
In the last few seasons, the Red Wings blue line has seen an injection of young blood. While Danny DeKeyser and Brendan Smith have already made their marks on the Wings, this season has seen the newest Detroit defenseman make the most of his shot at the NHL.
Xavier Ouellette will get there first. Ouellette, every game he plays, he's not going anywhere.
He made a great play there.
Xavier Ouellette once again was called up from Grand Rapids to fill a hole on the blue line. But this time, the native Frenchman is determined to earn a more permanent spot.
Every time I've been called up, it's been big excitement and a big deal for me. I mean, that's what I want to do. I want to be here, so I get really excited and I just want to play.
He's, you know, he looks like he's been around for a while. Doesn't play like a rookie whatsoever. Looks like he's been around for quite a few years.
After playing in four games last season, Ouellette has already quadrupled that number this season. He scored his first NHL point on November 22nd, notching an assist against Toronto before his first goal as a Red Wing 6 days later in New Jersey.
In front, but there's one, and the first National Hockey League goal for Xavier Ouellette.
I feel stronger. I've worked a lot on my skating too this summer, so I feel way more comfortable on the ice, and I think that's the biggest difference. I think the main part for me is to be consistent and play the same game every night and make sure they know exactly what to expect when I play.
A lesson Ouellette and all Red Wings D-men need to learn is when to jump up into the forecheck. Pinching on the boards and stepping into the play are just as crucial to success as blocking a shot or clearing the zone. For more, our Matt Shepard went on the attack.
There is a slight misconception about defensemen in the NHL. The position isn't just about checking, blocking shots, or forcing wingers to the perimeter anymore. Defensemen today need to contribute offensively as well.
Quincy goes after it, scores! Kyle Quincy!
It's not like 30 years ago when first goal wins and then you can kind of hold on and pin guys and, you know, our job's a lot harder than all the new rules of structure. We got to skate and be just as skilled as the forwards to kind of keep up with them. The new defensemen these days have to be a little more skilled.
I agree. I think, it's kind of a different game these days. NHL's changed a little bit over the years, and it's more about kind of having guys who can skate, who can move the puck and jump up on the play and, add offense for the team. So that's a lot of the ways, if you look around the league, that's how a lot of teams are getting their offense from.
Detroit's offense sure isn't lacking. They have incredible balance with five players scoring double-digit goals so far and nine players with at least 20 points. The Wings' defensive scoring may not be in the top half of the league, but sometimes numbers don't tell the whole story.
Do we execute well coming out of our zone so we have speed going in the offensive zone? Like, now they do all these possession stats, you read about it, and shots and all. And our analytics stuff doesn't match up with theirs, okay? The more we play in the offensive zone, the more active your D can be because you're on the cycle and you're being heavy. When we play good, our D are active. When we don't play good, our D aren't active.
So it's not as much about scoring as giving the team a chance to score, getting chances, and getting the puck back once a shot is taken.
It's important for the D-men to try to get in the play when they can. You know, we got three forwards, and a lot of times they're playing against five guys down low in the offensive zone. So it's important to try to get the fourth and the fifth guy in the rush when you can. And when you get the puck at the point, it's got to get through. You can't get it blocked. I guess if you have nothing, you put it back down low and let the forwards go to work.
Not just to score, but like you said, create scoring chances and open up room for the guys down low. A lot of times, you know, when the forwards give it up to us D-men, we got to make sure that we do something with the puck and not just give it back to their team. So that's one area we have to improve in.
Sure, but only as long as it doesn't affect their primary responsibility. It's nice to light the lamp, but the main job on defense is to prevent scoring.
Obviously, it is important. But you still gotta play good defense. You can't just play offense and forget about the defense. And I think the defense has been good for us, and now we can probably improve a little bit to get them a little bit more involved.
Our first job is to keep it out of our net, and if we can chip in and help out, that's a bonus.
Game to the line for Ouellette, a shot, yep. Scores! Oh, wow. Boy, the defense. Wingspan in on the goals tonight.
Have you ever tried to implement some of Datsuk's skills on the defensive end into your own game?
No.
When it comes to the all-time greats at the position, few teams can boast the glut of blue line heroes found in the Red Wings history book.
Lidstrom playing hard against Manderville. Now Lidstrom pokes it loose and it's cleared.
Red Kelly was the first defensive legend in a time of legends, lining up behind Detroit's famous production line while winning four Stanley Cups and the inaugural Norris Trophy for the league's best defenseman. It would be 30 years before Detroit saw a defenseman equal to Kelly, but a 20-year-old Nicklas Lidstrom would need some mentors to reach his potential. Enter Hall of Famer Larry Murphy, who paired with Lidstrom to help the Wings win their first cup since the Kelly era. Vladimir Konstantinov, Paul Coffey, Chris Chelios, and many more all continued the tradition of excellent Red Wing defensemen.
Hasek save, and Chelios there to corral the rebound.
And through it all was Lidstrom, the seven-time Norris Trophy winner and four-time Stanley Cup champion, who played the position so well, we called him perfect. Lidstrom's final project before his retirement was mentoring current Red Wings number one defenseman, Nicklas Cronwall. Now it's Cronwall's turn to pass on those lessons learned to the next generation of Red Wing defensemen. One thing all of those legends had in common was excellent support from their teammates up front. And for Detroit to catch Montreal and Tampa for the top spot in the Atlantic, every red and white clad skater needs to be at their very best in both zones. With a look at how this season's forwards are hustling on the back check, here's Mickey York.
They don't give out the trophy for nothing. Since 1978, the Frank J. Selke Trophy has been given annually to the league's top defensive forward. Pavel Datsyuk is the only active three-time winner in the game today.
Number 22 for St. Louis. Oh. Datsyuk again. Boy, he's no give up, is there? He took it once and then again.
You could see it coming. Dogged work by Datsyuk.
Have you ever tried to implement some of Datsuk's skills on the defensive end into your own game?
No.
If you try to replicate some of the things he does, you could get hurt, couldn't you?
You could.
One of those things you don't suggest trying at home?
Yeah, I don't think I suggest to try to anybody to do that.
But playing defense when you're a Red Wing forward is more than a suggestion. It's a recipe for success handed down by Selke-winning forefathers like Fedorov, Yzerman, and Draper. And it's executed in living color daily by disciples like Datsyuk and Zetterberg.
When your captains are some of the best offensive forwards in the league, it's easy to follow suit. Obviously they're extremely gifted offensively, but to watch them play in their own zone is amazing. And you can look around the league, and the best teams have good defensive forwards.
The same thing for me and Paul when we came in. We looked at Steve, we looked at Draper, looked at all the forwards that played here for a long time, and they were doing it right. So you just learn from them.
There was a time when forwards and defense went together about as well as salt and ice, but today's game demands defense be a total team effort.
Obviously, if you don't play a defense, like, the coach wouldn't be happy.
It takes the group of five, not just defensemen, but everyone on the ice to play defensive. But I think when you play good defense, that leads to a lot of chances offensively.
Having those guys come back and play hard in front of our own net or win battles in the corners is huge, because then you're playing in the offensive zone, you're not playing in your own end. And I think that's something that you take care of your defensive side first and you'll get offensive chances.
There's the real hook. Want a forward to play defense? Remind them it's the quickest way to get back on offense.
In Sweden, that's the first thing you learn, to play defense, and then after that you're allowed to play good offense.
Some players think offense first, and my role and some of the other guys on the team, we have to think defensively, and you don't take away from your offense too, but you got to be relied upon to be good defensively, game in and game out.
Obviously you love to score goals. That's part of why you play hockey, is the thrill of scoring goals. And hopefully I can get a few more here this year. But taking pride in defense and is what I got to do right now.
But what forward doesn't yearn for the good old days of the great Gretzky, when the NHL was goals galore and defense was played by D-men?
scoring 70, 80 goals a year would be fun, wouldn't it?
It would be. It would be, but you know, I'd rather take a lot of W's instead.
And there's no defense for that.
For me, it's just about doing your job. It's as simple as that, going out there and making saves for the guys and, you know, giving them a chance to win night in, night out.
Just like the defenders lined up in front of them, the netminder position has benefited from breakout performances from young wings. When dependable backup Jonas Gustafsson separated his shoulder early in November, the Wings brass called upon Grand Rapids goalie Peter Mrazek to back up starter Jimmy Howard.
Good save, Mrazek! Jager the shot and a save. Oh, look at Mrazek!
Mrazek played in his first NHL game back in February of 2013. The rookie displayed the most important skill for an NHL backup: be ready when called upon.
That was a great night and, you know, lots of memories. It was my first NHL game and, you know, so I didn't know what to expect before the game. You know, it was first game, so I was really, I really enjoyed it. You know, the win, that's the most important thing in hockey.
Since joining the big club this season, Mrazek has found himself with plenty of opportunities to prove he's an NHL-caliber player.
I feel really good. You know, I every practice with Jimmy Brar, you know, it helped me and, so I'm trying to be focused and the best job I can.
Good save, Mrazek!
Mrazek and Gustafsson find themselves with big pads to fill. Despite going down with an injury on January 10th, Red Wing starter Jimmy Howard had a remarkable first half of the season. The Wings hope to get Howard healthy as soon as possible so he can pick up right where he left off. Here's Justin White with more.
Makes the move, scores, Helm!
Night after night, a new hero seems to save the day and keep the winged wheel rolling. But it's the man who makes the saves who's been there just about every night.
Drop back to Soderberg, saved by Howard.
Halfway through the season, Jimmy Howard has been everything he and the Red Wings hoped he would be. Howard's on pace to put up the best numbers of his career.
It's been pretty good. There's obviously any goalie in the league probably want to have a couple back, but you know, for the most part, it's been a pretty good year, pretty consistent.
A rigorous off-season training program appears to be paying off. Carrying the load as a top goaltender can be a physical grind, but Howard says he's less fatigued than he's ever been before.
Sometimes, you know, you just your muscles need a little break, you know, day in and day out, like we, you know. You know, the way Babs puts us through pretty intense practices and games, you know, sometimes you're going to get, you know, little things here and there. But, you know, it's just sometimes you also got to fight through it.
High slot, saved by Howard. Rebound, Howard, stop that.
For the most part, Howard's body has cooperated, and his body of work has benefited. There have been nights when he's gone above and beyond to give his team a chance to win, even if Howard sees it differently.
For me, it's just about doing your job. It's as simple as that, going out there and making saves for the guys and, you know, giving them a chance to win night in and night out.
The guys who play in front of Howard have noticed a difference from day one. The Wings' defense has also improved this season, due in no small part to the guy who's got their back.
As a whole, you know, our system is all based around limiting the shots and exposure to him, but when, you know, things break down on the penalty kill, he's been there to help us out, so that's huge.
Well, I think it allows us to kind of have a little more freedom out there. Obviously, you don't want to give up chances, but, you know, if it comes down to that, we know that he's been playing well enough where he's going to, you know, he'll bail us out on more times than not. So it's kind of nice to know that. You know, at the same time, like I said, you don't want to give up those chances, but if we do, he's there.
He's been there and done that thus far. Jimmy Howard could be heading toward his best season as a Red Wing, but his focus remains on the puck and on helping his team win games.
I think if I just take care of everything out on the ice, then everything else just falls into place. You know, I don't really put too much stock into the numbers. You know, a lot of the times the goalie's numbers are based upon how well the team's playing in front of you. So, you know, the most important thing for me is night in and night out is getting 2 points.
Point shot! Oh, Jimmy Howard at the buzzer!
Whether it's a breakneck back check, a sniper shot from the point, a timely zone clear, or a stunning save, here in Detroit, the best offense is a great defense. As these Red Wings chase first place and a record-setting playoff run, the defense just keeps getting stronger, holding the line and defending the D. For all of us here at Fox Sports Detroit, I'm Trevor Thompson. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.